Hello, and a very warm welcome to the SubQuery Heroes course, making the world's decentralized data more accessible. First of all, let's jump in and take a look at what SubQuery is. It's an open source project that allows developers to do three main things: to index, transform, and query substrate chain data to power your applications. You can think of it like a Google for blockchains, where you can search for the data that you need, you can then transform it, and then serve it up to your front-end application very easily and very quickly. Now, what are the problems SubQuery is trying to solve? First of all, query speed. So, if you want to grab data from the blockchain now, it's actually quite challenging. First of all, you may have to spin up your own node, and that can take quite a bit of time, particularly trying to synchronize the data. Secondly, once you have a node, you need to be able to connect to it, typically via RPC connection. What SubQuery does is it provides this intermediate layer where it will grab the data for you. The data will then be transformed and indexed and made available via API. This makes grabbing the data very easy and very quick. The second problem is around parachain diversity. For example, trying to query data from different blockchains can be really challenging. What parachain diversity does is it allows you to grab data across different blockchains in a much simpler fashion. Let's take a closer look at this. So, traditionally, the Bitcoin blockchain is separate to, say, the Ethereum blockchain. However, in the Polkadot world, different blockchains are called parachains, and they are all connected together in the Polkadot network. So, for example, here, you can see Bitfrost and Moonbeam and Akala, for example. These are all parachains that run off the Polkadot system. To be able to extract information from these different blockchains, what SubQuery does is it allows you to query across these different parachains, aggregate the data, and be able to perform one simple query. So the diagram on the right you can see here, we can quickly find out how much does Alice have in her wallet across the Darwinia, Polkadot, and Akala substrate blockchain. So that's the second advantage that SubQuery provides. Now, jumping into the overview of the course, we first take a look at getting started. If we jump into the documentation here, this follows the quick start guide, where there is a Hello World project that you can follow to get familiar with SubQuery, to prepare your environment, and to get a project up and running really quickly. Once you've had a taste of how things work, we then jump into the basics of SubQuery. You can see here on the left-hand side, this covers, for example, the manifest file, the GraphQL schema, and the mappings file as well. In Module 3, we then look at relationships. What this means is that inside our GraphQL schema, the very important file where you effectively define the shape of your data, and we'll talk more about what this means in the course, we explore the one-to-one, the one-to-many, and the many-to-many relationships. After that, we look at SubQuery Project and SubQuery Explorer. In the top right-hand corner, you'll see Projects. If I click on this, SubQuery Project is a place where you can run your project hosted by SubQuery. Explorer is a place where you can search for other projects created by the community. You can utilize the projects here. You can search and try to learn how other people have created SubQuery projects as well. So it's an open community where projects are being shared. In Module 5, we'll take a look at aggregation. What this means is, once we have the data, how do we roll it up or sum or add together all the data to, for example, get the balance of a wallet? And towards the end in Module 6, we'll look at tips and tricks on how you can better build your subquery projects. So with that, feel free to contact us at the various means down below, either on Telegram, Twitter, LinkedIn, Medium, or GitHub. And we hope you enjoy the course.